Hi, welcome to physics class. Good morning, all of you. So yesterday we will discuss about YDS experiment in interference. Like this. Suppose this is a long cardboard. It is a long cardboard. S1 and S2 are the two pinholes made on the cardboard side by itself approximately. Separation between these two is equal to d, small d. Again, these two pinholes are illuminated with a monochromatic point-wise source S, which is kept at finite distance. Now, the light rays coming from the source S is made to incident on the cardboard such that the light rays coming from S1 as well as S2 both are interfered together to produce alternately bright and dark bands on the screen kept at a distance capital D, where capital D is equal to distance of the screen from the slits S1 and S2. But here capital D far greater than small d always. In general, small d is in millimeters and capital D is in meters. That's why capital D is far greater than small d. So at the midpoint of S1 and S2, that is, this is a perpendicular line drawn on the screen. Let this is the point O. From S1 to the light rays coming from S1 to reach the point O and also S2 to O, both will interfere together. That means the path length from S1 to O is equal to S2 to O. Path difference between these two waves is equal to 0. Path difference 0 means phase difference is also equal to 0. That's why at this point a bright band is formed, which is called as the central maxima or central bright. Central bright band is formed, CB, central bright band is formed at O. Again, let us consider one point P on the screen. The light rays coming from S1 to reach the point P. From S2 also, the light rays are moving along this direction. At the point P, these two waves are interfered together to produce either bright band or dark band. Here, at the point P, suppose it is a dark bright band. Compulsory, the path difference between the waves is equivalent to n lambda. Already we will discuss in the previous video. Suppose at P there is a dark band, compulsory the path difference between them is equal to 2n minus 1 into lambda by 2. Are you understand? Right. Suppose here from the midpoint of S1 and S2 a line is drawn, or this line and the point P is both are connected together like this. Let this line makes an angle theta with the line, horizontal line, so that from the point S1 also a perpendicular line is drawn on S2P. So clearly understood from the diagram, S1 to P, and also suppose this point is Q, Q to P both are same. Path length from S1 to P and also Q to P is same. Extra path difference travelled by the second light is equal to this is. This is the path difference, effective path difference between two light rays on reaching the point P. Suppose this angle theta. This angle is also equal to theta. Why? Suppose if the point P approaches to O, theta will be decreases. And this perpendicular line also approaches towards S2, theta will also decreases. As O, it is reaching, the point O reaching to the point P, that means perpendicular line also shifted to this distance, delta X. Right? Angle between S1, S2 and this perpendicular line is theta. And this is also equivalent to this line is also makes an angle theta with the horizontal. Clearly observed from this diagram, this is a right angle triangle. Vertical distance of the point P from the central maxima is equal to y. Say it is y. Vertical distance. From this right angle triangle, tan theta is equal. What is the value of tan theta? tan theta is equal to opposite side by hypotenuse, means opposite side y, hypotenuse is equal, sorry, adjacent side is d. Tan theta is equal to y by d. Tan theta is equal to y by d. Also, if theta is very small, if theta is very small, generally sine theta is approximately equal to tan theta. Right? From this smaller triangle S1, S2, Q, deeninchi sine theta is equal to, from triangle S1, S2, Q, sine theta is equal to, sin theta is equal to opposite side by hypotenuse, and delta x by small d. Therefore, delta x by small d, from this, delta x is equal to d sin theta. What is delta x? It is the path difference between two light rays on reaching the point P. Therefore, path difference between the two light rays on reaching the point P is given by S2P minus S1P. S2P minus S1P is equal to delta x. Delta x is also equal to d sin theta. It is very important, keep in memory. S2P minus S1P is equal to delta x. Delta x is also equal to d sin theta. This is the effective path difference between two light rays on reaching the point P. Now, resultant intensity. Suppose here, let the intensity of light coming from S1 is equal to I1, from S2 is equal to I2. These two light rays are interfere together to produce either bright or dark bands at P. Now the resultant intensity IR is equal to, you know, already this formula is derived in previous class. IR is equal to I1 plus I2 plus 2 root I1 root I2 cos phi, where phi is the phase difference between two light rays. Phi is the phase difference between two light rays. As the two slits S1 and S2, these two are also called as the coherent light sources. Coherent means they are having coherent. Any two light waves are said to be coherent when both are having same frequency, same wavelength, and also maintains a constant or zero phase difference. For example, let, in case of coherent waves, I1 is equal to I2 is equal to I, where I equal to intensity of light coming from each one. That is equal to I plus 2 root I into root I, means I into cos phi. Here I plus I is equal to 2I. So 2i into 1 plus cos phi, that is equal to 2i into, according to trigonometry, 1 plus cos theta is equal to formula 2 cos square theta by 2. 1 plus cos theta is equal to 2 cos square theta by 2. That's why 1 plus cos phi is equal to 2 cos square phi by 2. That should be equal to 4i into cos square phi by 2. This is the formula for intensity of the resulting wave on reaching the point P. Intensity of the resulting wave. IR is equal to 4i into cos square phi by 2. So, the resultant intensity IR depends only on the phase difference phi. Again, you know, phase difference phi is equal to 2 pi by lambda into path difference. This formula is well known formula. Relation between phase difference and path difference. Phi is equal to 2 pi by lambda into path difference is equal to delta x. Okay, now. Suppose here, condition for the maxima or bright fringe, or this type of interference is also called as Constructive interference. So in case of maxima or bright fringe or constructive interference, for maxima means intensity will be maximum. Intensity maximum means, from this relation, cos square phi by 2 is also equal to maxima. So IR is equal to maximum. That means 4i cos square 5 by 2 is also equal to maximum. So cos square 5 by 2 maximum value is equal to 1. Cos square 5 by 2 is also, when it is maximum, the resultant intensity is maximum. Cos square 5 by 2 maximum means 5 by 2 is equal to maximum means plus or minus 1. Cos function will be changes from plus or minus 1. So generally, you know, cos 0 is equal to 1. Cos 180 is also equal to 1. Square undi kada, minus 1 whole square means plus 1. So 5 by 2 is equal to 0 or pi r, 2 pi r, 3 pi and so on. Like this, phi is equal to, multiplying 2 on both sides, phi is equal to 0, 2 pi, 4 pi, 6 pi and so on, it is equal to 2 n pi. So in general, phi is equal to 2 n pi. Phi is equal to 2 n pi. So to produce the maximum, path difference between two light rays is equivalent to 2 n into pi. That means an even multiple of pi. Even multiple of pi. Right. Alani, at the same point, path difference is equal. So to produce the maximum, path difference delta x is equal to lambda by 2 pi into phi. Lambda by 2 pi into phi. Why? You know the formula, phase difference phi is equal to 2 pi by lambda into path difference. From this, delta x is equal to lambda by 2 pi into phi. That is equal to lambda by 2 pi into phi is equal to 2 n pi. So 2 pi cancel. It should be equal to n lambda. So path difference is equal to n lambda. And phase difference is equal to 2 n pi. These two are the conditions to produce interference maxima or bright band. Therefore, the maximum intensity is equal to, here what is? 4i. Because cos square 5 by 2 is equal to 1. Therefore, I maximum is equal to 4i. I maximum is equal to 4i. Next one, condition for minima. Condition for minima or dark band or dark fringe, or it is also called as the destructive interference for minima or dark band. Suppose here for minima, resultant intensity IR is equal to minimum. IR is equal to 4i into cos square 5 by 2 is equal to minimum. That's why cos square 5 by 2 minimum raavalante 0. Cos square 5 by 2 equal to 0. Therefore, phi is equivalent to pi r 3 pi r 5 pi and so on 2n minus 1 into pi. That's why phase difference phi is equal to general formula 2n minus 1 into pi for dark bands or interference minima. It is the path difference. Phase difference. Next, path difference between two light waves is given by path difference delta x is equal to lambda by 2 pi into phi, phase difference. That is lambda by 2 pi into phase difference is equal to 2n minus 1 into pi. Therefore, delta x is equal to 2n minus 1 into, here pi and pi cancelled, 2n minus 1 into lambda by 2. This is the condition for dark band or interference minima. Right, my dear students. So, what are the conditions for bright? For bright and also dark. For bright, phi is equal to 2n pi, and for dark, phi is equal to 2n minus 1 into pi, where n is taken from N is taken from 1, 2, 3 and so on. Yes. And path difference delta x is equal to here n lambda. Delta x is equal to 2n minus 1 into lambda by 2. These are the conditions for getting bright and dark bands in case of YDAC experiment. Now, let us explain some problems. So, the first problem is problems regarding the intensity. In YDAC experiment, the maximum intensity on the screen is I0. Find the intensity at a place where, first one, phase difference between two waves is pi by 3. Path difference between two waves is equal to lambda by 4. You know very well, intensity at any point IR is equal to 4i into cos square 5 by 2. So for 4i is equal to, you know, I maximum. 4i is equal to I maximum. Maximum intensity 4i into cos square 5 by 2. IR is equal to, according to the given problem, the maximum intensity on the screen is I0. So I maximum is equal to I0 and I0 is also equal to 4i. I0 cos square 5 by 2. Also given, phase difference phi is equal to pi by 3. So pi by 3 by 2 means pi by 6. Cos pi by 6 means 1 by 2. Cos square means 1 by 4. Therefore, resultant intensity IR is equal to 3 by 4 into I0. Okay, na? Right. So, second question is, find the resultant intensity at a place where the path difference between two waves is lambda by 4. Path difference. So, here, delta x is equal to lambda by 4. Again, you know, relation between phase difference and path difference is phi is equal to 2 pi by lambda into delta x. 2 pi by lambda into delta x is equal to lambda by 4. Lambda, lambda cancel. 2 1s, 2 2s and 5 by 2. Therefore, phi is equal to pi by 2. Resultant intensity IR is equal to I maximum into cos square 5 by 2. Because here, cos square 5 by 2. Cos square 5 by 2 means phi is equal to pi by 2. Phi is equal to pi by 2. Cos square 5 by 2 is equal to pi by, sorry, this is equal to I maximum into cos square. Phi is replaced by pi by 2. Pi by 2 by pi. And it means pi by 4. Cos pi by 4 means 1 by root 2. Square means by 2. So that is equal to IR is equal to I maximum by 2. So that is the resultant intensity at a path difference lambda by 4. Next, in the next question, in YDSE Young double slit experiment, capital D is equal to 1.2 meters. Means capital D means distance from slits and screen. Small d, distance between two slits is 0.25 centimeters. Lambda is equal to 6000 nanometers. Then calculate the distance y from the central maxima where the intensity on the screen is 75% of the maximum intensity. Are you understand? Resultant intensity at any point on the screen is 75% of the maximum intensity. Maximum intensity 4i. So therefore, IR is equal to 4i into cos square 5 by 2. 75 by 100 into 4i is equal to this value. 4i, 4i cancel. 25 3s, 25 4s. 3 by 4 is equal to cos square 5 by 2. Or cos 5 by 2 is equal to root 3 by 2. And 5 by 2 is equal to pi by 6. Because cos of this value is equal to root 3 by 2, this function should be equivalent to 30 degrees. 30 means pi by 6. Therefore, phi is equal to pi by 3. Corresponding path reference delta x is equal to lambda by 2 pi into phi. Lambda by 2 pi into pi by 3. Therefore, delta x is equal to lambda by 6. Delta x is equal to lambda by 6. Again, you know, the path reference delta x is equal to, already discussed that delta x is equal to d sin theta. D sin theta equal to lambda by 6. Sin theta is equal to lambda by 6d. Lambda 6000 into 10 power minus 9 by 6 into d equal to 0.25 into 10 power minus 2. Conversion into meters. on solving this, this is equivalent to 4 into 10 power minus 5. So, if theta is very small, sin theta is nearly equal to tan theta. Tan theta is also equal to 4 into 10 power minus 5. Tan theta is also equal to y by capital D, that is equal to 4 into 10 power minus 5. Therefore, y is equal to 4 into 10 power minus 5 into 1.2, that is equal to 4.8 into 10 power minus 5 meters. So, this is the distance of the, this is the distance of the point where the intensity becomes 75% of the maximum intensity on the screen from the central maxima. Remember this. Next problem. In YDSE, capital D 1 meter, small d 1 millimeter, lambda is equal to 5000 angstrom units. Calculate the intensity on the screen at a distance y is equal to 1 by 3 millimeters from the central maxima if intensity of the wave from each slit is I. Intensity of the light coming from each slit is equal to I. Find the value of intensity on the screen at a distance y equal to 1 by 3 millimeters. Y is equal to. Therefore, tan theta is equal to y by d. Y by d means 1 by 3 into 10 power minus 3 by 1. Tan theta is also equal to sin theta. This is equal to 10 power minus 3 by 3. So, this is sin theta. But you know, path reference delta x is equal to d sin theta. 10 power minus 3 into 1 by 3 into 10 power minus 3 is equal to 1 by 3 into 10 power minus 6. Corresponding phase difference phi is equal to 2 pi by lambda into delta x. I am solving it 4 pi by 3. Therefore, intensity IR is equal to 4i into cos square phi by 2. 4i into cos square phi is equal to 4 pi by 3. 4 pi by 3 by 2. That means 2 ones are 2 twos. Cos 2 pi by 3. 2 pi by 3 means 120. Cos 120 is equal to minus 1 by 2 whole square. 1 by 4, 4, 4 cancel. Therefore, resultant intensity IR is also equal to I. Right? Next one. Let us find out the number of maximas or number of minimas. Number of maxima and number of minimas. So, it is one very important. This is the YDSE experiment. S1 and S2 are the two slits. These two are illuminated by a light coming from a point-wise monochromatic source, yes. Separation between them is the screen is kept at a distance capital D and capital D is far greater than small d. So, this is a perpendicular line drawn on the screen from the midpoint of S1 and S2. That means always at this point there is a central bright region or bright band. So, according to interference experiment, alternate bright and dark bands are formed on the screen means central bright, first dark, first bright, second dark, second bright.